it's good to see you today. We're glad that you're joining us. I want to share with you some information about when we're going to start up our services here at Ray of Hope. Get an update. I'm sure you're ready for one. But I do want to give you just some of the national and Oklahoma updates, because as of April the 29th, the Oklahoma cases, we have risen 63. We're at 3,473. It's a 1.8% increase. The Oklahoma deaths, 214, increase of 7, a 3.4% increase. Nationally, there's over a million cases of COVID-19 viruses, 1,012,582. It's a 2.5% increase, and there are 58,355 deaths, a 3.7% increase. Now, Governor Stitt and the Oklahoma State Department of Health has issued some recommendations and policies for places of worship, and there are three phases: phase one, phase two, phase three. And beginning on May the 1st, they're going to implement phase number one, which the first Sunday in phase one is actually May the 3rd. Now, many other churches are going to begin their services, I'm sure, on May the 3rd. However, we will not begin at Ray of Hope until May the 10th. Now, the reason that we're not going to begin until May the 10th is the numbers that I just read to you. Even though our percentages are lower and our increases are smaller, we're going to show you a graph here just in a moment where there is still an increase, and we've not really flattened out quite like we should. So we want to, when I say we, our leaders, our elders, our deacons, our staff here at Ray of Hope, we want to give an extra week, and we think that that extra week will help us be safer. The safety of our congregation and the health of our congregation is an utmost priority for all of us. We want you to be spiritually healthy, but we also want you to be physically healthy. So we will not begin our services until May the 10th, and we will have our 10:45 a.m. morning service. So that's going to be on May the 10th. Now, let me just say this again. The reason is because the numbers are still increasing, although not at a higher rate. We want to be as safe as possible. So thank God for good leadership. And that 1 week wait, I think, will help everyone just feel better and give us a safer option into our getting back into our normal services. Now, here's some of the guidelines that the CDC, the Oklahoma State Department of Health, along with Governor Stitt, has recommended and implemented for this phase one going into phase two, phase three. So I want to go over those with you, so when we get into our services, you'll be familiar with what's going on and what you will face. Those who are sick and with a temperature obviously should not be coming to the service. You should stay home, watch it online, and that would be a great thing. It's suggested that members abstain, refrain from shaking hands, hugging, and if you know me, I'm a handshaker, I'm a hugger, so that's going to be a little awkward, but it's just going to be good to see each other. So we're looking forward to that. Also, we're not allowed to serve food or drink, which means, oh, God forbid, no coffee and donuts. That's coming, but right now they're saying that we should not serve coffee and donuts. Maybe our waistline will be better if we don't serve those things. Our children's nursery and our children's hall will not be open. They're recommending and saying that we have to close that. So there'll be no child care. But if you choose to bring your children, that's up to you. You can bring them right in here to the sanctuary to worship and sit with you. But that is your prerogative, your choice. But we will not be having a nursery or a children's ministry for those first Sundays. Every other row is recommended to be cordoned off and to remain empty. We will do some. However, if we have enough people that will come, if you choose to sit in an area that's not cordoned off or spaced, that is up to you. So we're not going to turn anyone away. We'd love to have you here for every service. And if you come, we'll do our best, because we want to maintain social distancing. But if we get close to one another, that's people's choice. I'm not the police, and I'm not the pew police for sure. But we will have places for you to take your family and set apart, 6 feet apart for that spacing if you choose. And certainly we recommend that, but that's up to you. But we're not going to turn anyone away that comes to our services. We'll have some places closed off, but not every place will be closed off. So set in the place where you're comfortable. If you choose to wear a face mask, that is certainly up to you. You can come in with one, but the volunteers and the staff, according to the guidelines, are required to wear masks when you're entering the building. Our worship team will not be wearing masks as they sing and play, but they will be socially distanced on the platform and they'll be away from you. I will not be preaching with a mask, although some of you may want me to put a mask on when I start, but we're going to be as safe as possible in our first services. But let me just reiterate, our greeters will probably be wearing masks. As you come in, you'll see them. Now, if you choose to wear a mask to come to service, that's great. If you feel comfortable wearing a mask, we would love for you to wear your mask. If you don't wear a mask, we're not going to turn you away. We're going to welcome you. That's your choice. But if you feel safer doing that, please do that. So phase one begins the 1st of May. Let me just reiterate again so I don't have any confusion. We will not be having our first service on that first Sunday of May, which will be May the 3rd. Please watch us online. I'm sure other people will be opening up their places of worship. We feel it's just safer. We feel like we're going to be more responsible if we just wait one more week to let this thing pass by a little bit further down the road. So May 10th. First service, 10:45, service only, no Sunday morning classes, no nursery, no children's ministry, 10:45 only. We will not have Sunday night service. We will not have Wednesday night service. So that first week, 10:45 service only. Let's fill up the house. Let's get back together. I'm looking forward to that. And then we move into phase two. So phase two begins on May the 15th. But the first Sunday will be May the 17th. We will still be having our 10:45 morning service. We will not be having our 8:30 service. That will come later. So we'll be here at 10:45. We possibly, now I say possibly, will start beginning to have our 9:30 Sunday morning classes. Now that's contingent on, and all of this is contingent on, that this progresses according to the Oklahoma State Health Department and our governor's office. So we'll just see if this continues to go on as planned. So phase two begins May 15th. First Sunday of that phase two is May the 17th. We'll have our 10:45 morning service. Our children's nursery and children's ministries and areas for children's ministry will be open on May the 17th. So you can bring your children. If you want to place them in the nursery, please feel free to do that. We'll have our children's church, children's playground, children's crafts, ministries, all of that will be open on May the 17th. So phase two will be in place for May the 17th, May 24th, and May the 31st. We're still not able to serve food or drink yet. No coffee, no donuts. But that brings us to phase three. Now, phase three begins on June the 1st. So beginning the 1st of June, we will go back to all of our normal services. So we'll have our 8:30 service. We'll have our morning classes starting at 9:30. We'll have our 10:45 morning service. We'll have our Sunday evening service that will start at 6 o'clock in the evening. Now, we're able on June the 1st, which will not be, that will be a Friday, but the next Sunday, we'll be able to serve coffee, we'll be able to serve donuts, our Wednesday night meal will be back in full force, so we want you to come and have that evening meal on Wednesday, all of our classes will open up, All of our service will be back to normal, quote, whatever normal is. So we're looking forward to that. And we're really looking forward to having you here and me being with you. We've been away way too long. And I know this has been difficult. A lot of things that we've had to do, I didn't want to do. My life is not disrupted maybe as much as others. People are struggling with their job. They're struggling with people who are sick. They're trying to, you know, stay as safe as they can. We understand that. But listen, we're here to worship God. We're here to praise God. We're here to be a fellowship and a community of believers that's changing our world. We're trying to be the change, having that koinonia, that spiritual fellowship that we need to have. And listen, I'm really excited. I've got a lot of pent-up stuff within me that when we get together, this is going to be great. We're going to worship together. We're going to clap together, raise our hands together. We're going to shout together. We're going to serve God together, worship Him in spirit and in truth. But we're really kind of limited at this beginning. I like to just pull out all stops, let's go, but we want to be good stewards and obey those that have rule over us, kind of a Romans 13 to, you know, give credence to the governor and those who are in places of authority. But yet, we're still ready to go. So I'm looking forward to you being here. And listen, if you've never been to Ray of Hope, let me invite you to be here. This is a great place. Some of the greatest people in Stevens County and this entire region go worship and attend right here. We're not into religion. We're not into denomination. But we really are into relationship with Jesus Christ and serving God our Father. So we want you to know, we believe in the fullness of the Holy Spirit. We feel the passion of God working in our life. So as we get ready to come back, let's get our mind focused. Let's get our hearts ready. Let's get pumped up for worship and bring somebody with you. If you're not a Christ follower, come and listen. And I think you will serve the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. So we're going to put the information up. If you have any questions, call the office, and we'll be really happy to get you plugged in and get you back into whatever's normal now. So we're hoping to see you really soon. Let me say again, May the 10th, 10:45, looking to see you here. God bless you.